Next, Frank and Mary here in Framingham with your host, Grace O'Donnell, and me, Art Bergeron. Our guest today is Michelle Guzziardi, Assistant Program Coordinator for the Metro West Shine Program. If you want to learn more about how to choose the right Medicare plan for you, please stay tuned.
Welcome to this episode of Frank and Mary in Framingham. I'm Grace O'Donnell, Director of Elder Services at the Callahan Center.
And I'm Art Bergeron. My day job is as an elder law attorney at Myrick O'Connell. There are 70 of us at Myrick O'Connell. Everybody gets to do what they like. I like doing this. This is clearly not my day job, though. This show is not about elder law. It's about my friends Frank and Mary and their kids, Peter, Paul, and Mary Jr. Frank and Mary's goal in life is to live in their house until they die and be buried in the backyard. And if that's in Framingham, they want to stay right here. They want to know the people that they need to know and the programs that they need to know about in order to stay right here in Framingham for the rest of their lives. And my great co-host, Grace O'Donnell, is the person who always finds these people from kind of out of nowhere. So Grace, who do we have today?
Hi, Arthur. Our guest today is Michelle Guzziardi. She's the Assistant Program Coordinator of the Metro West Shine Program. What is the Shine Program, you ask? Well, Shine stands for Serving the Health Information Needs of Everyone on Medicare.
That's a great summary of what Shine is. I'm dying to hear more about how the program works. This is the time of year to be starting to think about, you know, what Shine means to you. So Michelle, can you talk to us a little bit about this? Why should seniors care about talking to you about Medicare?
Yes, thank you so much for having me today. Yes, so I'll tell you a little bit more about Shine. Shine offers free and unbiased health insurance counseling information assistance to those Medicare beneficiaries who are residents of Massachusetts, as well as their caregivers, and also those who are approaching Medicare eligibility age. The program is administered by the Massachusetts Executive Office of Elder Affairs under a grant through the Administration for Community Living. We have over 600 volunteer SHINE counselors throughout the state of Massachusetts. The Metro West region has 22 cities and towns that we serve and over 50 volunteer SHINE counselors. We usually provide one-on-one counseling for SHINE at our local senior centers, but obviously that has changed right now. And to bring it back to Frank and Mary and how SHINE can help Frank and Mary, their goal is to stay in their home, stay in Framingham, and thrive there for as long as possible. One way to do that we feel is important is to make sure that they have the health insurance coverage that is best for them, for their individual situation as they age. That might mean making sure they have a premium that's affordable for them, making sure they have the best coverage for them given their particular health needs, making sure they can avoid large surprise medical bills or sticker shock at the pharmacy when they go to pick up their meds and realize their med that usually costs $10 is now $200 and what happened there. And also if Frank and Mary are having any trouble kind of making ends meet at the end of the month, they would really benefit from seeing a SHINE counselor who could help screen them for benefits. There are many assistance programs out there that can help defray the costs of Medicare for folks, and SHINE counselors are trained to ask the questions to see if Frank and Mary might qualify for those types of programs. And even a little bit of savings can help put more money back into Frank and Mary's pockets so they can stay at home for as long as possible. So that's why we feel it's important to know about SHINE and what we do and to see a SHINE counselor.
Michelle, can I ask you, since right now senior centers are closed physically to the public for their own safety, how are people able to access SHINE counseling now?
Our counselors have transitioned really seamlessly to doing their counseling all remotely by phone right now. So that means they're essentially taking appointments that would have been in person at senior centers and just doing them over the phone with folks. The best way to reach our SHINE counselors is to call your local senior center and to ask for an appointment with the SHINE counselor. So in Framingham, obviously that's the Callahan Center. So you want to reach out to them, their phone number, 508-532-5980. We are very lucky to have 7 wonderful SHINE counselors that work out of the Callahan Center that are ready to take phone appointments with folks in the Framingham area. So definitely give them a call and get on the list to see and to speak with the SHINE counselor by phone. Counseling by phone is not ideal for our program. Obviously, we're dealing with a very complex subject matter, and ideally, we'd be seeing folks in person. Right now, it's just not safe to do that. So our counselors are really wonderful. They're doing everything possible, really going above and beyond to make sure that they can get the information across to people in ways that is understandable over the phone. Yeah.
You just said 2 things that really go above and beyond what I think Frank and Mary and a lot of seniors think about SHINE. They think about 2 things. 1, how's my drug plan working, right? Mm-hmm. And I know that every year, and once again, and seniors are really aware of this, that every year the drug that might have been on my plan before, even if I have the same plan the next year, might have gone, or the price may have changed, any number of things may have happened. So every year you actually have to go through this drill, you know, to make sure that your stuff is still there. And every year you, on the good side, you have the ability to say, well, you know, my health is changing, right, for good or bad. And so the drugs may be different next year. And so I get the chance to figure out ahead of time what plan is going to work best for my drug. And that's what most folks think of. And that's the end. But you talked about really 2 other things. The one that we talked about kind of before the program, which is this is also a good time to be thinking about whether your regular Medicare plan is the plan for you, whether your combination of Medicare A and Medicare B and whatever you're paying typically as a supplement is costing you more and is giving you more than what you could otherwise get by getting on a Medicare Advantage plan. And then the other thing you just mentioned was there may be some programs that can help supplement Frank and Mary's insurance costs, you know, which they wouldn't necessarily know existed. So that's really fascinating.
It's really never too late, and there's no wrong time to reevaluate the coverage that you're on. Absolutely. You don't have to wait until open enrollment. Certainly it's helpful because you have more options to change during open enrollment period, but it's never too late. There's never a wrong time to come in, see a SHINE counselor, just kind of get educated about what other options are out there. We often see folks that sort of picked a plan maybe at age 65, and that was the right plan for them at the time. But now maybe they're in their late 70s, their health situation has changed, they're on different medications, they have different priorities, maybe their income and assets have changed. So it behooves folks at any age to really reevaluate their coverage regularly. And SHINE counselors are here year round to work with folks. So there's really no wrong time to come in and meet with the SHINE counselor.
And this may actually be kind of a good time because it's just before open enrollments.
And to get back to your other point about screening for benefits, yes, it's a huge part of what SHINE counselors do, which folks might not kind of associate with us. But for everyone that comes through our doors, or everyone who picks up the phone with us, we are asking them about their income and assets, not because we want to be nosy, but just because we want to see if there's any programs out there that they might qualify for that might help them. Folks might be surprised. They might say, oh, yeah, my income's way too high, or yeah, I've got money in the bank, I've got assets, I'm not going to qualify. But they'd be surprised that there are some programs out there, some that don't look at assets at all, and some where the income levels are relatively high. So they might be able to get assistance that they didn't think was possible. So that's really important.
Michelle, I was wondering, now with Social Security offices also being closed at this time, how do people go about even signing on for Medicare in the first place?
The enrollment for Medicare does have to go through Social Security. And it's true that the offices have been closed because of COVID-19. Some transactions have always been able to be done online or by phone or over the, you know, through the mail. But Social Security has really made a great effort to expand their flexibility for enrollments that are done online by phone or through the mail. They've even added a new online option. So before COVID-19, this option didn't exist. But for folks who are in a specific situation where they're over the age of 65, they have delayed their Part B enrollment. Maybe they're 68 years old, but they've been working, they're employed, and they're getting coverage through their employer, or they're a spouse of someone who's working and is getting coverage through their that spouse's employer. Those folks, we're seeing many of them that are unfortunately choosing to retire or unfortunately getting laid off. So those folks now have this new option through Social Security of going online and doing an online enrollment to get into Part B, where they would have had to go into the office to do that prior to COVID. So that's, I mean, that's a huge adjustment for Social Security to do that, and obviously very important right now for folks so they can get that enrollment in Medicare done as soon as possible. And a lot of folks are, you know, would prefer to do something online, certainly. So SHINE counselors are being trained and kept up to date on all these changes. So we can really walk folks through, okay, what's that website on Social Security for signing up for Part B? What documents do I need to have or upload for the application? SHINE counselors can walk you through all of that. And Social Security is saying that once they receive these applications, they're still processing them in a normal time frame. They're processing them normally. But certainly we would encourage folks to start that process of enrollment sooner rather than later, just to be on the safe side.
Just to make sure I heard correctly, people who don't have access to a computer, for instance, they can call mm-hmm. the Social Security office to
Absolutely.
Register online. Mm-hmm.
Yes. So the best way is to call your local Social Security office. So for each zip code, there's a certain Social Security office that's kind of dedicated for, you know, for those particular zip codes. So on Social Security website, ssa.gov, there's an office locator. So you put in your zip code, it'll tell you which is your local office. And there should be a local phone number where you can reach that local office. And then you can explain to them your situation. They'll tell you what forms you need to fill out, and usually there you would mail them directly into the Social Security office, or they can be faxed as well.
How has COVID-19 affected Medicare?
Well, beyond that expanded enrollment flexibility with Social Security that we talked about, Medicare has also temporarily expanded their benefits to cover telehealth. And as you know, telehealth visits have become much more commonplace in the last few months. Yeah. So Medicare is recognizing that and temporarily expanding those benefits. They're also covering the COVID-19 lab testing, and there's no out-of-pocket costs for COVID testing for Medicare beneficiaries. Antibody testing for COVID also it can be covered in certain situations. If and when a vaccine becomes available, it will be covered by Medicare as well. Great. And if you're in a Medicare Advantage plan, then you have access to these same benefits as well as folks who are on original Medicare. And if you want to learn more about all that Medicare has done in terms of adjustments related to COVID-19, you can go to medicare.gov and you'll see a link right there on the homepage for more information on the coronavirus.
Oh, terrific. Okay. So once somebody enrolls in Social Security and Medicare, are they done? Is that it? They're good forever? They never have to do anything else?
I wish. It would make it a lot easier. For most people, the enrollment in A and B is really just the beginning. So I'll explain a little bit about Medicare for a few minutes here, if you'll allow me. So Part A, as we may know, is hospital insurance, and that's free for most people. Part B is doctors or medical insurance, and that always has a premium associated with it that folks have to pay. And A and B together is what we call original Medicare. Original Medicare is not meant to be comprehensive insurance. It is designed to have gaps in the form of copays, coinsurance, and deductibles. For example, you might be familiar with Part B and the gaps there. So after you reach the Medicare Part B deductible, which is $198, then Medicare pays 80% and you pay 20%. So when you think about paying 20% for all of your doctor's visits for an entire year, that can really add up. That's just if you had original Medicare, that's what you would be subject to. So that's why most people decide to supplement their original Medicare with some additional coverage. And that additional coverage takes two forms, and there's basically two options. The first option, I will say one other thing that folks, it's important. No matter which option you choose, you still have to have your Part A and your Part B. So there's no way around that. You still have to have Part A and B and pay for B. But the first option that you could choose to supplement Original Medicare would be to choose a Medigap plan. A Medigap plan will cover some or most of those gaps in Original Medicare. Some of the benefits of a Medigap would be that you don't need referrals to see a specialist, that you can see any doctor across the country who takes Medicare. And because neither Original Medicare nor Medigaps include drug coverage, you would still need to get a separate standalone drug plan, or what we call a Part D plan. Okay, so that's option one. Option two for supplementing your Original Medicare is to choose a Medicare Advantage plan or a Part C plan. These take the form in Massachusetts of an HMO or a PPO. And many folks might already be familiar with how an HMO works. You need referrals when you go see specialists. You might be restricted to a particular provider network. And you pay co-pays as you utilize the healthcare system. And these Medicare Advantage plans, they include drug coverage, sort of all rolled into one. And with these Medicare Advantage plans, there's also often extra benefits above and beyond what Original Medicare will cover. So these Medicare Advantage plans, extra benefits might include some dental coverage, vision, hearing. There might be an allowance for over-the-counter products like Tylenol or Advil. There is often a reimbursement for things like exercise classes. So some nice extra benefits, but because they're extra, they vary completely from plan to plan. So you really have to investigate, okay, what are those extra add-ons with this plan versus that plan, because they're not standardized. And at this point, this is where we might see Frank and Mary's head kind of start to spin as they think about all these different options and how to choose. So that's really
They already are. I could see Frank's expression turn into a frown. And Katie's going to be scratching his head going, oh my God, you know, I thought I retired so I wouldn't have to think like this, you know?
Yeah, Medicare is quite complicated, but that's where Shine Counselors come in, because we can kind of explain all this to folks in language that is easy to understand, and we can really talk to them about, okay, what's important to you about your coverage specifically? Is it really important that you can see whatever doctor you want without having to worry about a referral or a network? Is it really important to you to have a low monthly premium? As we kind of talk about those things, we can help you kind of flesh out what is what's most important to you, and then what type of plan would be best for you. We are never going to tell someone which plan to pick. That's not how Shine works. We're just going to give you the information to be able to make that decision for yourself. Yeah. And this is true whether you're just going on to Medicare for the first time, or like we said before, if you're someone who's been on Medicare for years, it's still important to kind of reevaluate what the best plan is for you and what your needs are, because your needs can change over time.
That last point is just crucial, to understand that every year is a new year, you know, that the plans change, but you change also. And so to be able to keep looking at this is really, really important. And to not have, and to know you can count on the Shine person isn't trying to sell you anything.
Right. Correct.
The Shine person is not trying to sell you anything. The Shine person is your tax dollars together with some wonderful volunteers at work, right? Mm-hmm. So that you can make your way through to help you make your way through this system.
Right. You can know that Shine Counselors are, you're right, we're not getting paid by any insurance company. We have no, you know, stake in the game in terms of what you choose. Our goal is to make sure that you get the best plan for you, whatever it is, absolutely.
Right. Now, Michelle, I know there are a lot of different drug plans out there available mm-hmm. for people in terms of paying for their prescription coverage. How do people even start to compare which plan is the best for them?
If you choose the option of a Medicare Advantage plan, remember that your drugs are already kind of rolled into that plan. So what you'd really just have to do with the Medicare Advantage route is, you know, double check the formulary, make sure that your drugs are included on the formulary, and see if they're covered kind of at a reasonable cost. If you go the other route of the original Medicare with a standalone drug plan or Part D plan, yes, there are over 20 drug plans sold in Massachusetts this year, and they vary from a $13 premium to over $100 a month premium. Wow. There's huge variation in these drug plans. It really is important to choose the right one for you. Some of the factors that I would encourage someone to think about as they're choosing a drug plan would be, you know, does it cover my medications? Does it have quantity limits on my medication? So that, say, I can only get 30 pills a month of something that I need to get 60 pills a month of. Does it require a prior authorization from my doctor to get my medication? That's another hoop to jump through. Mm-hmm. And can I get the best price at my neighborhood pharmacy? Because I only want to go to that pharmacy. I don't want to go anywhere else. I want the best deal there. So those are some of the things that I would consider. It can be sort of overwhelming to kind of try to think about which plan out of 20 some odd is the best one. So Medicare has designed an online tool called the Medicare Plan Finder. Anyone can access this tool by going to medicare.gov. When you get there, you'll see that they're going to ask you to create a mymedicare.gov account. At Shine, we highly recommend folks take the 5 or 10 minutes to set up this online account. Why? It's going to give you personalized results as you do these searches to compare plans. It's also going to allow you to save your medication list onto the Medicare.gov website. So let's say you take 10 or 15 medications. You don't want to have to keep typing those in every time you're ready to compare plans each year. If you set up this MyMedicare.gov account, it's already saved right in there from year to year. There is a step-by-step video out there that will walk you through how to set up a MyMedicare.gov account. I am going to share my screen so that I can show you how to get to that video. I'm going to a website called shinema.org, shinema as in Massachusetts.org. This is a statewide Shine website where you can find really excellent information about the Shine program and about a lot of the topics that Shine counselors would cover in an appointment with folks. So if you scroll down to the About Shine section, in this third box over here where it says My Medicare Account, tells you a little bit about what a My Medicare Account is. And then way down at the bottom here, you will see a link at the very bottom for this instructional step-by-step video. I won't click on it now, but that's where you would go, and it sort of walks you through the process. It's really not very cumbersome to set up a MyMedicare.gov account. You do need a Medicare number to do so, though. Once you do have that MyMedicare.gov account, you go back into the plan finder, you input your medications, you can start comparing plans. And we suggest that folks sort them by what the lowest overall cost is. So then the one that comes up to the top is going to be the cheapest. And then you can start doing your comparison and start to look at what plan might be best for you.
Anything new this year? I know not the plans don't always finalize until just before open enrollment in October. But is there anything new this year that people should be aware of?
There definitely is. There's one important thing that I would like to spend a couple minutes talking about. And it goes back to that topic of screening for benefit programs that folks might be eligible for. Again, it's a big piece of what Shine counselors do. We talked about there's various state and federal programs out there that can help cover the costs of Medicare. And there are even a few that don't look at assets. They all have a different income range, from everything from MassHealth Standard that has the most strict income limits to something like the state's Prescription Assistance Program, which is called Prescription Advantage, has the highest income limits. But the one I want to talk about today is one that has had a pretty significant change this year in 2020, and that is the Medicare Savings Programs. They're also known as the MassHealth Buy-In Programs, or Buy-In Programs. You might have heard of them by those names. They have expanded the eligibility, the financial eligibility for these programs starting in January of 2020, which is really great news for folks across Massachusetts because it means more folks are now eligible for the excellent benefits under these Medicare savings programs. So the Medicare savings programs, they cover the entire Part B premium for everyone that is on those programs. They also can cover co-pays and deductibles for some qualified individuals as well. And all Medicare savings programs include excellent benefits for drug coverage as well. I'll give an example. If someone going on a Medicare savings program, they might take a $10,000 a month medication, you know, one of those really expensive meds. Once they're on the Medicare savings program and they have what we call full extra health benefit, that $10,000 a month drug could now be $8 a month or even less than that. So wow. Really remarkable savings that you could see when they get onto these Medicare savings programs. And not only is it a huge cost savings, but it is really the easiest application out there in terms of completing. It's only a 2-page application. Okay. And right now the state is not requiring that any verifications be submitted up front with this application. So that means you don't have to, you can just attest to what your income and assets are. You don't have to prove what they are. They might ask for information later on, but up front they're not going to. So I'm going to share my screen again for just a second, and I'm going to actually show you where you can find the link to that application and show you how easy it really is to fill out. And again, this is something that the SHINE counselor absolutely is able to help you out with, but it's something that folks are able to do on their own as well. So I'm back at shinema.org. I'm clicking on MassHealth at the top. Tells you about the different MassHealth programs. The one we're looking at is this MassHealth buy-in right at the middle. If we go down to applications, the link here, MassHealth buy-in for people who are eligible for Medicare, is going to take us right into the application. Honestly, the instruction pages are a lot longer than the actual application. We've got several pages of instructions, but the application itself, here it is, page 1. Pretty straightforward. You fill out your income information here, assets information here, you sign it, and then you can mail it, or we recommend faxing if you have access to fax. This ended off to MassHealth. And I'm just gonna zoom in a little bit here so that you can see what the, I won't go into too much detail here, but you can see what the income and asset limits are. If you are an individual, that's the top box. And if you're a married couple, there's the bottom box there for the different levels of the Medicare savings program. So again, we think that this is one of the, you know, the biggest changes for 2020 so far is in Massachusetts, more folks are eligible for these programs. Again, huge, could be huge, absolutely huge savings for folks, especially in terms of those, you know, the drug costs, but also, you know, everyone on the Medicare savings program gets that Medicare Part B premium paid for by the state. So that's, again, any savings is good in terms of SHINE.
We have a few minutes left, Michelle. Can you just briefly tell people when open enrollment starts and what its purpose is?
Right. Open enrollment, and we've talked about it a little bit, but open enrollment runs October 15th through December 7th. Each year. And that's the time that folks who are already on Medicare can change their drug plan or their Medicare Advantage plan. And again, we encourage everyone to reevaluate their plans during the open enrollment time, because the insurers will come out in the beginning of October and they will announce the changes for the next calendar year for their plans. And remember, they can change virtually everything about the plan from one calendar year to the next. Mm-hmm. So for example, in last year, in 2019, one plan not only changed the name of its drug plan, but also doubled the premium from $30 a month to $60 a month.
Wow.
So if folks weren't paying attention, in January, they were really surprised to be paying a lot more for their drug plan. So, you know, to bring it back to Mary again one more time, she might be in a drug plan that she really loves, but in October, the plan announces that they're doubling the premium. Her favorite pharmacy down the street is no longer a preferred pharmacy, so she can't get the best deals there. And it's no longer covering that really important med that she takes. So that's why, you know, she'd be really surprised in January to come find those things out. It's really important for her to come in during open enrollment and see a counselor, talk about what's changing with her plan and does it still work for her.
This is unbelievably useful. Grace, thanks for doing this. And Michelle, thanks for doing this. I think, folks, the bottom line is you have to talk to her or you have to talk to one of these folks. No normal person will figure this out. You need to have a specialist who is on your side, you know, with your taxpayer dollars at work, to help you figure out how to get the best deal. And by the way, you're still stuck with COVID-19. You're spending more time at home. What better way to spend time at home than by saving money on your Medicare? So thank you very much, you know, Michelle, for doing this. Thank you, Grace, for once again being a great guest. Thanks, folks, for watching. And we'll look forward to seeing you on the next installment of Frank and Mary here in Framingham.